Hey, what's up, YouTube? Jacob Stibbe here, and I haven't done a video in a while, but I wanted to do a video on something that I think is kind of cool, and I want to start doing more of these types of videos, too. But what this video is today is it's about this guitar. This guitar is a 2010 / Epiphone Appetite for Destruction signature model. So this guitar was one of the first guitars that I've ever purchased and the first guitar I really ever had. So I got this guitar in the fall of 2010 and started taking lessons on it. This is literally what I learned on and played my first gigs on. I think I have some pictures of some first gigs. Yeah, they're total cringe, but here you go. So I've had this, like I said, since 2010. And what attracted me at the time, I was 13 when I got it, was just the Gibson look of it. It looked like a Gibson. I mean, Epiphones at the time didn't have the Clouston style tulip kind of tuners unless it was on a SIG model, of course. Now a lot of them do. And then this one has the butterscotch flame top, which I just thought, like I said, it looked total vintage Gibson-y and just total rock and roll, and I just love the aesthetic of it. Yeah, it's been played to death. I've used it on national tours, a backup guitar, and I've used it at tons of gigs, even recently in the past couple of years. I really do think this is a great sounding guitar. So now, as you can tell visually, the guitar looks pretty beat up, and it did not come relic'd. Epiphone does not make a relic'd option. The way this happened was by an accident that happened on stage. So one time on stage, I was standing there, I was like 15 years old, and had my strap on, but didn't have the darn strap lock things at the time, and I think I did a stretch and the guitar just fell down. So the guitar fell and hit the corner of the stage. I was stage right and there was a sharp corner and it caused this gnarly looking rash thing. I don't know what you call it, a ding. I mean, it's huge. So because of that, I had this beautiful, clean, polished guitar with no marks on it because I really tried to take care of it, and then you had this giant thing on it. So then I decided I needed to make this thing not look so damn bad, so I decided to relic it myself just to make the guitar look like it was intentionally supposed to be like that. And when I was like I said, I was like 15, 16, I tried my best to do it and did the vinegar salt thing and sandpaper, and I even took a blowtorch to it, and then the whole damn thing caught on fire by accident one time, but it still works. Yeah, all of the hardware and everything's original. It's got the Slash Alnico pickups. They sound great. I think Epiphone gets a bad rap due to the fact that they're cheaper guitars. I don't know. But I think Epiphone guitars are great. I think if you gave this guitar to Slash to use for a big show, he would do it. I mean, I've used it several times, so you could tour with this thing easily. It feels great, stays in tune, sounds good. And for the value of the buck, I would buy another one of these any day, and I'd recommend anybody to buy something like this. Slash has several signature models with Epiphone. And he has, before this, there was a gold top Les Paul, a tobacco burst Les Paul, and then there's the Firebird, then an Anaconda burst more recently. And new to 2020 is the Slash Gibson collection, which debuted at NAMM, and I think it's all these guitars. They have this one too. But yeah, it's all of those, but they're Gibson versions. They look cool. So I have this guitar going through a RJS 76-100, which is basically a 2203 Marshall Circuit. The guy that builds these amps named Bobby Smith out of Colorado. And yeah, he built just hand-wired vintage Marshall tones, so sounds great. Now, I'm not using a speaker cab. I have the Saint Rock React IR, and but yeah, it's just one of the presets that came with it, and that's just going directly into my interface. And I have MXR carbon copy, delay, and the reverb, the MXR reverb through the loop, the FX loop of the amp, and it's just kind of filling up some dead space, but that's it. That's how the guitar sounds. I think it sounds pretty good. Let me know your thoughts in the comments section. Hopefully all nice things. Bear with me too on my GNR riffage. I didn't practice or I learned them or whatever. I kind of vaguely remember them, but I just try my best to replicate them. So I might not be playing them right, but you get the point. But yeah, the guitar itself I think is a great guitar, and I think it's a great sounding guitar. I highly recommend purchasing one of these through like Reverb if you find a killer deal on a used one. And I'm sure the newer Slash stuff from Epiphone, and just Epiphones in general, don't be afraid to buy one. They're great guitars, and like, there's really nothing wrong with them except for this mind thing of like, they're cheap, so they're not that good. But you can make any guitar sound good. It's your hands, dude. Well, anyways, I hope you enjoyed this, and I'll be making more of these. Let me know your thoughts. So yeah, party on. See ya.